Now that we've talked a little bit about how to get back to editing your sketches, let's talk about how to edit your features. Very similar to the sketches, you can select them inside of the feature tree and go to Edit Feature. Now, the quick context menu that pops up is the quickest way that you can get access to it from the tree, but you can also right-click and get that same menu as well. You can also select a face that belongs to that feature on the screen, get access to the quick context menu that pops up here, as well as the breadcrumbs to go directly to edit that feature. But there are a few other things that we need to be aware of with features that are a little bit more complicated than sketches. Now, when we select Boss Extrude 1 from the tree on our Drafted Wheel 3 SOLIDWORKS part, you notice that we get access to the blue dimensions which belong to the feature. And you'll notice that the tooltip that pops up just below our cursor tells you exactly what dimension they are, D3 at Boss Extrude 1 and D1 at Boss Extrude 1. Well, what's D2 at Boss Extrude 1? Is there a D2? Is there something that we're missing here? Is there something else that we need to know about this design? Well, all the information that you manipulate or enter in a feature will be available to you when you select that feature from the tree, when you select it on the screen, or when you select it from the breadcrumbs. For instance, if we selected something like this edge that belonged to Sketch 1, you'll notice that it allows us to select the edge, and even though nothing was selected on the screen, Boss Extrude 1 still shows up, and we have access to those. But like many features, there are multiple options that you may or may not use when you first create that feature. For instance, in this case, we started from a sketch plane. We used a blind end condition, gave it a dimension of 0.5, and we linked to our global variable 1 degree. Now, this does not allow us to directly access adding a direction to, manipulating the from condition if we decided to offset it, for instance. Let's say that we wanted to offset it 0.25 in the other direction, and then we want to manipulate this to be 0.75. Now, these are dimensions that you can add, but if you haven't used them in the feature originally, you're not going to have access to them when you simply select it on the screen. So you might have to go back into the feature to manipulate some details of that specific feature. Now, there are too many features for me to talk about, but every feature has its own set of different options. For instance, inside of Rib, if we edit this, we can modify which direction the thickness goes. We can modify whether it's at sketch plane or wall interference. We can modify the direction. We can modify the side the material is going to. We can determine if it's linear or a natural extension, and so on. So based on whatever feature you're manipulating, you might want to think about, do I need to just select it and change this dimension? I only want to offset it 0.125 instead of 0.25. And do I want this dimension to be a blind end condition or from a certain place? So we can go back into Boss Extrude 1 and say that we want this dimension to be 0.5, but we want it to be from a surface or offset from a surface. And in this case, let's say that that surface is a plane. We zoom out. Let's say that it's going to be our front plane. So that way we can manipulate these values, for instance, this back offset, if we want this to be 0.25 now, and not affect where this end face goes, because now we've added this 0.5 dimension from a fixed point in our modeling environment. And these are things that you have to go back into the feature to manipulate if you want to change them in some sort of logical fashion. If the dimensions are there, simply select it on the feature tree, select it on the screen, and you can get access to all that information. These are just a few ways that you can get back into these features and start manipulating to help improve your designs.